Oh, this hair is like wired. Feels so weird. It almost feels very dirty. I don't know.
Hey guys, welcome to Dolls Made Me Do It. My name is Mick, and before I get into this Bratz haul, if you enjoy dolls and toys as much as I do, please make sure to subscribe to my channel as I post regular doll content such as doll reviews, unboxings, hauls, you know, all that fun stuff we love spending hours watching on our phone. If you have not watched part one or part two of my Bratz haul, these are dolls that I've accumulated in the last few weeks. I think the total count was about 84-ish, and I felt that was way too much to show all in a video, so I split the haul into several parts. If you want to watch part one, I will link it in the card above, and if you want to watch part two, I'll link it in the description down below. Starting with haul number three, I will begin with the few babies that I got. I don't collect the Bratz babies, however, I do think they're cute, and since they were part of this haul, I snatched them up. I don't know all the collections that they belong to, but the first one is Bratz Babies Fiona, and she's so cute. She is the baby with the hard molded hair, and I believe further releases had the rooted hair. She's very clean, very cute, you know. Her ponytail is still intact. She has her little outfit, so happy with that. The next baby is Yasmin, and she is the baby with rooted hair and is wearing a full outfit. Now, I don't know if it's her original. I think so, because there's a little frog, and I know that was her type of animal. She is wearing a little crown as well, and her hair is still an original style, but quite messy and definitely needs a wash, which is what all these dolls are gonna get after I'm done with them. Bratz Babies number three is Sasha, and she's super cute as well. Little pigtails and micro braids, also wearing a little tiara in a little like two-piece lingerie, like pajama set, I guess. She does have a little mark on her forehead that I'm hoping I could remove right up here, but overall, cute little doll. Now getting into the actual dolls, I will start the haul with Passion for Fashion Chloe. She is the tanned version, and I don't know exactly which Passion for Fashion line she comes from. I believe she's wearing one of her original outfits. Her hair is tied in an elastic, but it doesn't seem to be cut, so I'm hoping it's not. She is wearing a tiara as well that I know doesn't belong to her. I mean, this face, like, ugh, gorgeous. A tan Chloe is very, very pretty. She is wearing a full outfit at least, with some shoes that I don't believe belong to her, but that's her. Next up is Bratz Play Sports Yasmin, and she's definitely not wearing her original outfit, and her hair is out of her original style, but I think this is one of the prettiest Yasmin screenings. I love the bright makeup, and yeah, she's super pretty. I mean, now that the hair is out of its style, it is really long and nice. I don't know what she's wearing. I believe it's Bratz, but it's definitely not a dress. I mean, a little short dress, but if anyone can help me ID that, would be awesome. And then she's wearing some shoes. Cute. Next up is Forever Diamonds Fiona, and she is not wearing her outfit, but so pretty. This doll, ugh, look at that face. Very, very cute. One way of identifying a Forever Diamonds is that they usually have these little diamante stickers on their cheeks, so quite easy to ID. I love her. I think she's super pretty, similar to Yasmin in my opinion, but she does have a little difference in her face. Wearing a top that says free on it with some glittery denim and some silver pumps, which is cute. So again, fully dressed. Like, all these dolls are pretty much fully dressed. Again, most of these dolls are not in the original outfits, but they are fully dressed nonetheless, so that's a plus in my book. Next we have what I believe to be a Canadian release of the Play Sports Ice Hockey Chloe, and her outfit definitely is not what she's supposed to be wearing, but my friend Dale helped me out, and we think that this is her based on her screening. Such a pretty Chloe. Her eyes are like gray, but they have like these little pink stars in them, and just a pretty face. Her hair does feel like Kineclon. It's very fluffy. Her outfit's a choice. It's a lot going on. I don't know if this is a Bratz outfit, but it's all connected into one piece. It's interesting, you know? Next up is Feeling Pretty Sasha, and this doll is so pretty. Ugh. I mean, she's in really nice condition. Her face is gorgeous. Gorgeous. I love the like green makeup and the pink lip and that little like side stare. I believe she's in her one of her original outfits with this cute top, these little capris, and these lime green three strap pumps. So cute. Really like her a lot. To have her. Next up we have Bratz Pretty in Punk Yasmin, and wowza, I love this doll. This is such like a unique face and look for a Yasmin doll. I mean, if I hadn't like done research and looked her up, I wouldn't have thought this was a Yasmin. I would have thought this was like a different character. She does have her staple beauty mark, and I just love the shade of this like copper brown that she has and the blue highlights in her hair. just awesome. I don't know what she's wearing. I'm pretty sure this is not any of her actual outfit, but super pretty doll. Really happy to have her.
Wow.
Next up is a first in my collection. I've never actually owned a doll from this line. It is the Bratz Midnight Dance Megan doll, and I believe she's in her full outfit, which is really awesome. Great condition, this dark plum lipstick and this beautiful eyeshadow and these turquoise eyes, like, oh, I can, she's so pretty. And her hair is not cut, super nice. Obviously, again, all these dolls need some conditioner and a brush, but still beautiful. Now, she is missing one shoe. What I have not shown in these hauls is that some of these dolls came with extra clothing and extra shoes. Obviously, everything is super mixed, so I need to really like dissect all of it and try to piece things together. And from what I could see, I think I'll be able to reconstruct some original looks, which I'd love to achieve. I've missed out on the original like days of Bratz. I have a lot to catch up on, and unfortunately a lot of these dolls are not super attainable to buy new in box off eBay. So, you know, when these hauls come along and I can piece as much of them together as possible, I'm happy. I get to add them to my collection, so it's cool. So in the next bunch of dolls I'll be showing, there is some sort of a pattern, I think, because from each collection there are two dolls that I got, so that's pretty awesome. Like, these dolls I just showed are pretty much like single dolls from different sets, but these all have like a pair, which is really fun. I'll begin with Bratz Dynamite Chloe, and I think this is such a pretty Chloe. I love her face. I love this like very bright makeup, this fuchsia eyeshadow with some yellow and this beautiful pink lip. And she, I believe, is wearing her full outfit. Again, missing shoes, but I'm hoping to find them in that pile of accessories that I was given. Hair still seems to be in an original style, and she also has her sunglasses attached to her head. Next up in the Bratz Dynamite collection, I have Nevra, and she is wearing a princess top. Her original shorts, I believe, and I know there are pieces that go onto this outfit with a jacket. She's wearing princess shoes, which is always amazing to find in any haul that you buy used. Her hair is definitely in need of some help. It is rough, it's not feeling nice. Her bangs are covering her beautiful face. Again, the Bratz Dynamite dolls really have vibrant makeup that I really like, and yeah, she's no exception to that. Super beautiful turquoise eyes. Next up, we are bringing some magic into this haul, and I got a Bratz Genie Magic Yasmin doll. She's definitely not wearing her outfit. So she's wearing the Play Sports doll that we saw earlier, which is cool. I believe these are her second pair of boots from her second outfit, and these dolls are easier to identify because they have the tattoos on the arms, which is really cool. Sometimes they have the original gems on their foreheads, but this one is missing hers. However, her hair does seem to be in its original style. And to go with Yasmin, I got a Sasha doll. So she was also in this lot, wearing original outfit. Most of the jewelry and accessories are missing. Her hair, again, is rough, but in its original style. This Sasha, guys, is like, I mean, I don't know. She's just mesmerizing. I love looking at her. Really excited to do her hair and to clean her up, so that's gonna be a lot of fun. Oh, no. So there was one boy hiding in this lot, and he is not in a pair. However, it is the Bratz Funk Out Cameron doll, and he is wearing Dylan's outfit, I believe. I don't really collect the boys. I do find them cute, but I mean, I don't know. Maybe I'll keep a few from all the hauls that I got recently, but this is Cameron. Going back to the sets, we have Bratz Campfire Phoebe, and guys, in a Bratz Princess Yasmin outfit, which is amazing. I believe we have her shoes here, so this seems to be like somewhat of a completion going on. She has a really pretty screening. Hair is not an original style, but super long, so it doesn't seem to be cut. And wearing these white little boots. Cute, I like her. And to go along with her in the campfire line, I did manage to get a Yasmin. She's wearing Genie Magic top, I believe, and I don't know where this skirt is from. Maybe a Play Sports or something. Cute little pink shoes. And I don't know, guys, if this campfire Yasmin is supposed to have little like bangs or if this was cut, but I have a feeling it was cut, which makes me really sad. Not the worst, you know, choppiest thing I've ever seen. And overall, she does seem in nice condition. She does have a mark on her face that I'm hoping I'll be able to remove. Something I've been using that's been really helping is just a magic eraser. For these little scuffs, sometimes you just like rub it on and it goes away, which is really cool. We are at the final four, guys. Thank you for hanging in there. So next up are some of my favorites from this haul, and we have the Bratz Magic Hair Chloe doll. I mean,
Her hair is super coarse. Like, I've never actually seen any of the magic hair dolls in person, so I didn't know that their hair was this wiry. I think it had to do something with the whole hair play aspect, which makes sense. And I have been told that these wash up really nice and you can like really restore their hair really well. So I'm really excited to make her over. Face is almost like perfect. No scuffs of the sort, just needs a little bit of a clean. I love her screening. I think these are her jeans and her shoes, but I don't know if this is her top. I think it is. It is quite damaged, though. There's a lot of fraying that happened here, so I will try to make that look better. Such a pretty doll. And to go with Chloe, I got Yasmin. She's definitely not wearing her original outfit, but her hair is not cut at all. It seems to have been in an elastic for a while, so it kind of took that shape. So I'm really excited to boil wash her. Such a pretty face. I don't know where this is from. It's kind of cute. Oh, I think this is actually Ever After High. Now that I'm looking at it, I've been like puzzled looking at it, and I think this is Apple White's Dragon Games top, maybe, that belonged under her armor. I have to check that, but that's what I think she's wearing. And shoes that definitely don't even match her skin tone. But again, all these dolls are in full outfits, so I'm not gonna complain. And drum roll for the final two dolls. We have not one, but two Bratz princess dolls. I mean, like, what? Finding these out in the wild, especially in the condition that these are in, for like $3 or $5, like, what? I'll start with the first of the two, and it is Bratz princess Yasmin. And I mean, I love purple. I think it's one of my favorite colors with blue, and she's just so beautiful. I love her eye makeup. She does have some little specks on her face that I'm hoping come off with the magic eraser method. Her hair is not an original style, but it just needs to be cleaned. It's really not cut, which is really nice. She still has her cute bangs. So I believe she's wearing Bratz Dynamite's Nevera's jacket. And then this outfit belongs to a Yasmin, and I don't remember which collection she's from, but I know it's a Yasmin doll anyway. And she's wearing the Campfire Yasmin shoes. So from what I'm seeing in this lot, plus with the extra accessories, I think I'll be able to complete quite a few dolls, and that makes me so happy. And to conclude this haul, we have Bratz Princess Fiona, and such a pretty face, gorgeous doll. I mean, she's wearing her jacket, she's wearing a skirt. She is wearing that Yasmin's top that goes with this Yasmin's outfit, but I don't have the doll in this lot, so I just know those belong to her. She's wearing campfire boots, and I think these belong to Roxy, but I could be wrong. Super excited to have her. So guys, I don't even know what number we're at in terms of dolls. So just in this lot, we have 22 dolls, and I think in the last video, there's like another 20, maybe another 20 in the first. I do have a pile of dolls left, so if you guys want me to conclude this with a part 4, please let me know down in the comments below. Looking back at all the haul videos I've just posted, maybe we can pick out a few together. You can let me know in the comments below which dolls you want to see me make over. And if there are dolls that keep coming up, I may choose those and add them to my first makeover video. I genuinely am enjoying making content for you guys, and if there's anything that I can create that is something you really want to see, that makes it even more fun for me. If you want to participate in choosing which dolls I should make over next, leave a comment down below with those dolls, or you can go to my Instagram and just shoot me a DM and let me know which dolls from there. Friendly reminder to please subscribe to my channel if you're enjoying this content and want to see more Bratz on my channel, and make sure to hit that notification bell so you're always the first to know when I put out a new video. And you can follow me on Instagram at dollsmademedoit, where you can see more of my doll photography, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Who's next?